STAND-IN GROOM by Kaye Dacus, read by the author. Nothing like running late to make a wonderful first impression. Anne Hawthorne left a voicemail message for her blind date, explaining her tardiness, then crossed her office to the gilt-framed mirror that reflected the view of Town Square through the front windows. At a buzzing jolt against her waist, she flinched, smearing her lipstick. Great. The vibrating cell phone chimed out a wedding march. A client. She reached for a tissue to repair her mouth while flipping the phone open with her left hand. Happy Endings Incorporated, this is Anne Hawthorne. I can't do it. I can't marry him. Third call today. Why had she agreed to be set up on a date the Thursday of a wedding week? If it were just the regular weekly dinner with her cousins, she could skip out and get some work done. Calm down, she said to her client. Take a deep breath and another. Let it out slowly. Now, tell me what happened. 15 minutes later, still on the phone, she pulled her dark green Chrysler Sebring convertible into a parking space in front of Palermo's Italian Grill. She sat in the car a few minutes, air conditioner running full blast, and listened to the rest of her client's story. When the girl paused to breathe, Anne leaped at her chance. I completely understand your concern. But, sweetie, you have to remember, most men aren't interested in the minute details of a wedding. Just because he doesn't care if the roses are white, variegated with pink, or solid pink, don't take that to mean he doesn't love you anymore. Which ones do you like the best? The variegated roses, the bride-to-be sniffled into the phone. Anne turned off the engine and got out of the car. The heat and humidity typical for the first day of June in central Louisiana wrapped her in a sweaty embrace. Then get the flowers you like. He will be happy because you're happy. Do you want me to call the florist in the morning? One more change the day before the wedding. Saturday couldn't come fast enough. Do you mind? That's what I'm here for. She opened her planner and made a note at the top of the 2-page spread for tomorrow. Feeling better? Yes. Thanks, Miss Anne. I've got to call Jared and apologize. See y'all tomorrow. Anne made sure her phone was set to vibrate only mode and entered the most popular new restaurant in Bonterra. Maybe she should have left the planner in the car, but she would have felt naked, incomplete without it. The heavenly aroma of garlic, basil, and oregano mixed with the unmistakable yeasty scent of fresh bread and wafted on the cool air that blew in her face when she opened the door. Her salivary glands kicked into overdrive and her stomach growled. She really needed to stop skipping lunch. Winding through the crowd of patrons awaiting tables, Anne scanned faces for the man her cousin Jen had been absolutely dying to set her up with for months. She'd made a point of watching a local news broadcast on Channel 6 last night so she'd know what he looked like. Miss Anne! A young woman in a white tuxedo shirt and black slacks came out from behind the high, dark wood stand and threw her arms around Anne's waist. She recognized the girl as a bridesmaid in a wedding she'd coordinated just a month or so ago. What was her name? Hey, sweetie, it's so good to see you. How are you? The bubbly brunette stepped back. I'm great. I'll be getting my degree in August, and I already have job offers from advertising agencies in Baton Rouge and Houston. Anne smiled, remembering the girl in a pewter floor-length straight skirt with a corset-style bodice. The bride had let each of the girls choose which style top they were most comfortable in. Gray bridesmaids' dresses, purple and lavender florals and bunting, the Garrity Latrobe wedding, 6 female attendants. Of course. How exciting. Congratulations, Carrie. Thanks. Are you meeting someone here? I am, but I don't see him. The reservation was for 7:15 under my name. The girl ran her French manicured acrylic nails down the waiting list and stopped at a crossed out line. Here you are. They were getting ready to reassign your table, so you got here just in time. Follow me, please. Walking through the packed restaurant behind the slender, petite young woman, Anne tried not to feel self-conscious. At nearly 6 feet tall and doing well to keep herself fitting into a size 18, she hated to imagine what others thought when they compared her to someone like this little hostess, 5'4"-ish with a waist so small she could probably wear Anne's gold filigree anklet as a belt. When working, Anne rarely thought about her stature or size. In public, though, all the comments and teasings she'd received when she'd reached her full height at age 13 rushed back into her memory. If only she'd had some athletic ability, she might have been popular and not fallen for a man who'd strung her along until he didn't need her anymore. "Here we are!" Carrie gave a bedimpled grin and bounced away. "Thank you." Anne chose the chair facing the entry and set her purse on the floor and her planner on the table. She glanced at her watch again. 7:30 on the nose. Surely her date wouldn't have given up waiting on her after only 15 minutes. "Still waiting on someone?" The young waiter, probably a student at the Bonterra branch of the University of Louisiana, handed her a thick, faux leather-bound menu. "Not that I want to be." "Yes, he's probably just running a little late."
"Can I go ahead and get you something to drink while you wait?"
"Sprite with cherry and a twist of lime, please." She turned her attention to the menu, pleased to see the broad range of selections. The waiter returned with her soda.
"Here you are. Can I get you an appetizer while you wait?"
She probably shouldn't, but... "I'd like the fried calamari and crawfish tails, please, with the cayenne parmesan dipping sauce."
"Excellent choice. My favorite."
She listened to the specials, making a mental note of the eggplant roulade.
"I'll be back with your appetizer in a little bit."
He glanced at the still empty chair across from her, but didn't comment before walking away. Anne set the menu aside and zipped open her camel-colored leather planner. Taking out a legal pad and pen, she reviewed her notes all over the two-page spread for today and the notes for tomorrow, then wrote out a to-do list of what she still needed to accomplish before her 8 o'clock meeting with the bride, groom, and minister in the morning. The waiter returned with the calamari and crawfish tails and eyed the empty place as he set the dish on the table.
"Do you want to wait until your companion arrives before you order?"
Maybe she should call to see what was going on. "Give me a few minutes?" He nodded. Grabbing her purse but leaving the planner on the table, Anne crossed the restaurant to the quieter lobby area outside the restrooms. She dialed and pressed the small cell phone to her ear. Without ringing once, his voicemail picked up. His outgoing message gave his office phone number, which she repeated in her head while waiting for the tone. She left her number and disconnected, then called his office phone. After a couple of clicks and an ad for the TV station, someone picked up.
"KCAN Newsroom, how can I help you?"
"Hi, I'm trying to get in touch with Danny Mendoza."
"Is this Anne Hawthorne?"
the female on the other end asked. Frowning, Anne started to pace.
"Yes?" "I'm so sorry I didn't have time to call you before now. Danny got called in on a breaking news assignment and will be out in the field for the rest of the evening. He asked me to let you know he wouldn't be able to meet you, but that he would call you tomorrow."
She squeezed her eyes closed and rubbed her forehead. "Thanks for letting me know. If you talk to him again this evening, tell him..."
"What? Thanks for standing me up?" "Never mind. I'll just leave a message on his cell phone."
Anne ended the call, hooked the phone back on her waistband, and returned to her table. The aroma from the fried squid and crawfish on the plate in front of her tantalized her taste buds.
"Any word?"
The waiter returned and tipped his head at the empty chair.
"Yes, he got called in to work, so won't be coming."
"Oh, I'm sorry. Do you want me to box this up for you?"
"If you could bring me a box, that would be great, because I'll never be able to eat all this and a meal, too."
"You mean, you're going to stay?"
Anne tried not to laugh at his surprised expression.
"Of course. I've been waiting to eat here for a month. I'm going to have the eggplant roulade, with the eggplant grilled instead of fried."
"Yes, ma'am. I'll go place your order now and bring you another drink."
"Don't forget the box for this."
Anne served a few pieces of crawfish and calamari onto the small appetizer plate. Jen always liked Anne to bring home leftovers after dining out to see what other restaurants were doing. At the thought of her restaurateur cousin, Anne shook her head. This was the third time Jen had set Anne up on a blind date, and the third time it hadn't worked out. Jen had a habit of setting Anne up with men of Jen's tastes rather than Anne's type. At 5'6", Jen didn't have to worry about towering over her dates. 5 inches taller, however, Anne wanted to date someone who was at least 6 feet tall, so she didn't feel like quite such an Amazon beside him. But it seemed as though tall, single Christian men over the age of 30 were hard to come by. Of course, every man Anne had gone out with in the past, who had matched her ideal of the perfect man, had ended up being perfectly wrong for her. Maybe she needed to stop focusing on the physical type and just get out and have fun meeting new people. She spent her life making others' dreams come true. Well, it was time for Anne Hawthorne, wedding and event planner extraordinaire, to start creating her own happy ending.